Hello everyone, welcome back to Cinta DIY. And today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet a basic tank top, which is really easy pattern and friendly for beginners. In this tutorial, I also showing you how to make it bigger and how to measuring it on your body. For this top, I'm making in size small. Okay, now let's get into the video. First, we are start making the bottom part of the top. To begin, make a slip knot. And chain 110. It is equal 26 inches length. It's the measurement around my under bust. If you guys want your top bigger, please add more chains. After you reach your desired fit, next, we are going to connect the foundation chains together. Make sure that your foundation chains doesn't twist. Continue from where your last stitch is and make slip stitch into the first chain. To make slip stitch, insert the hook into the loop. Yarn over and pull through all the loops. Next, we are going to make lemon peel stitch for row 1, chain 1, and make single crochet. To make single crochet, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 2 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all 2 loops. After you have made a single crochet, then we are going to make a double crochet into the next stitch. To make double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2, and yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. After you have made a double crochet, then we are going to make single crochet into the next stitch. Next, keep alternating single crochet and double crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. And this is what the first row of lemon peel stitch looks like. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work. Skip one stitch that near chain 1. So for the last stitch of my first row, I end with a single crochet stitch. And for the next stitch or the second row, I will start with a double crochet stitch. After you have made a double crochet, then make single crochet stitch. Remember, above the double crochet stitch must be a single crochet stitch. And above a single crochet stitch must be a double crochet stitch. Keep alternating single crochet and double crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row. You guys can use stitch marker to mark at this first stitch to know where we start and end the row. Then make slip stitch into the stitch that you mark. Next, for row 3, chain 1, turn your work, skip one stitch, and for the last stitch of my second row is end with a double crochet stitch, so I have to make a single crochet above the double crochet. You guys can use stitch marker to mark at this first stitch. Keep alternating single crochet and double crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch to connect the row. For the next row, please keep repeating row 2 and row 3 until you reach row 25. It is equal 6 inches length, is the height of my top. If you guys want your top longer, please add more rows. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 25, and it's measuring from the underarm part to my waist. Next, we are going to make the crease for the underarm part, which is where the curved part of the tank top. To begin, fold your top into two pieces like this and use stitch marker to mark at the other side. And this is what it should look like. Next, continue from where your last stitch is and start counting the new row again. For row 1, chain 1, turn your work. Skip one stitch that near chain 1 and we are going to make single crochet decrease by make single crochet 2 together. To make single crochet decrease, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 2 loops on your hook. Then continue insert the hook into the next loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 3 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. And this is how we make single crochet 2 together. Don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at decreasing stitch. It's easy to know where to start and end the row. Next, we are going to make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until you have 3 last stitches from the stitch marker. Then I will meet you back again. After you have 3 last stitches from the stitch marker, then we are going to make single crochet decrease by make single crochet 3 together. It is the same thing like we did in the beginning of the row, but for this one we have to insert the hook into 3 loops. After you got 4 loops on your hook, then yarn over and pull through all 4 loops. And this is how we make single crochet 3 together. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work. Skip one stitch that near chain 1 and make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until you have 2 last stitches from the stitch marker. Then I will meet you back again. After you had 2 last stitches from the stitch marker, then we are going to make decrease by make single crochet 2 together. After you have made decreasing stitch, then remove the stitch marker. For the next row, please keep repeating row 2 until you reach row 12. It is equal 7 inches length. Thank you. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 12. Measuring from here to here, it is equal 7 inches length. If you guys want this chest part smaller, you can keep making decreasing stitch, or if you think it's too small, you can make less decreasing stitch. Next, continue from where your last stitch is. Start from row 13 until row 21. Chain 1, turn your work and make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until the end of the row. So start from row 13, we are not making decreasing stitch. Measuring from row 1 at the underarm part where we made decrease until row 21, it is equal 5 inches length. It's the height from the underarm to my neck. If you guys want it longer, please add more rows. Next, we are going to make the neckline or the strap part of the top. Fold this into two pieces and use stitch marker to mark at the middle part. Then count 5 stitches away from the stitch marker. And use stitch marker to mark at the 5th stitch. Count the same number to the other side. Measuring from the first stitch marker until the third stitch marker, it is equal 3 inches length. Next, we are going to make decreasing stitch. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is. For row 22, chain 1, turn your work, and make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until you have 2 last stitches from the stitch marker. Then we are going to make decrease. after you had two last stitches from the stitch marker. So don't count the stitch where we mark, just count from the next stitch. Then we are going to make single crochet decrease by making single crochet two together. Next, for row 23, chain 1, turn your work. Skip one stitch that near chain 1 and make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until the end of the row. For the next row, keep repeating row 22 and row 23 until you reach row 27. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 27. Please keep decreasing if you want the strap more smaller and make less decreasing stitch if you want the strap bigger. Start from row 28 until row 30, chain 1, turn your work, and make lemon peel stitch until the end of the row. So start from row 28, we are not making decreasing stitch. After you reach row 30, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Again, measuring from row 1, which is where the underarm part, until row 30, which is where the top of the shoulder. It is equal 9 inches length. If you guys want it longer, please add more rows at the strap part. Next, we are going to make the other side strap. Turn your work and we are working from the stitch marker. To begin, skip the stitch that we mark and attach the yarn into the next stitch. For row 1, chain 1. Skip one stitch that you had attached the yarn and make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until the end of the row. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work, make lemon peel stitch until you have two last stitches, Then we are going to make decrease by making single crochet 2 together. After you have made single crochet decrease, for the next row, please keep repeating row 1 and row 2 until you reach row 6. Then start from row 7 until row 9, just make no more lemon peel stitch, no decrease. After you reach row 9, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Remember, both sides must be have the same number of the stitches and the same number of the row. Next, we are going to repeat the same thing to the other side. As you can see, this is the right side of the stitch. We are going to turn the top and working on the wrong side of the stitch. As you can see, this is the decreasing stitch. And we are going to attach the yarn into this corner part. After you had attached the yarn for row 1, chain 1. Make decreasing stitch by making single crochet 2 together. Then continue make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until you have 3 last stitches, then I will meet you back again. After you have 3 last stitches, then we are going to make single crochet decrease by making single crochet 3 together. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work, skip one stitch that near chain 1, and make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until you have 2 last stitches, then we are going to make decrease by making single crochet 2 together. For the next row, we are going to repeat row 2 until you reach row 12. It is the same number like the first side. And for the rest part, we are going to repeat the same thing like we did at the first side. Next, we are going to connect the strap together by sewing both stitches together. Don't forget to turn the strap wrong side out. We are going to sew it on the wrong side. Thank you. And this is what it looks like on the right side of the strap. Next, repeat the same thing to the other strap. For the next part, we are going to make single crochet around this armhole. To begin, attach the yarn into the underarm part. Then chain one and make single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch. Chain one and cut off the yarn. For the remaining yarn, please use the needle to weave in. Next, we are going to make single crochet around the neckline. To begin, attach the yarn and chain one. Then make single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the chain one stitch. Then make slip stitch, chain one, and cut off the yarn. And this is what your tank top looks like. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.